Your money's
How's yourself?
No,
that money!
Is that what you're looking in for?
How you doing, pal?
Good fight.
Okay, we'll start with the first half today because it was a great performance as far as I was concerned. I thought there were some great passes from the boys and obviously we got a reward by going in there.
I thought the first 15-20 minutes of the game was pretty even and pretty scrappy, tight. And then we get our break in the box and they finish as well. Whereas maybe weeks before we wouldn't have got that break in the box, but I thought we maybe just deserved to be in front of half time. But second half we'll come out and we don't start at all for 15 minutes. And I've said to the press, I said to the boys at the end of the game that the Big Arn's changed the game for us.
Yeah.
Where he saves it at 1-0, they're vital. Two fantastic stops, and then we got our second goal, and then I thought we're comfortable after that.
Yeah, I mean, I'd said to him, I would mention him in today's interview because I thought, as you were saying, he did change the game for us. I mean, he's quietly gone about his business really for us, isn't he?
It's very unusual for me to praise a goalkeeper.
He's been great.
I don't know how many clean sheets he has in the last, especially in this wee run of games that we're having just now, but it's great. And it breeds confidence and it gives you a platform to go and hopefully go and win from football matches.
Yeah. Great for Martin as well, come on today and get a brace near the end there. It's got to do his confidence, the world of good.
Yeah, we've seen that to the end. There's nothing better than the striker scoring goals. And he struggled a bit of late, the big lad, trying to get in the team as well. I thought young Sean was excellent, considering that's his senior debut in football. So we congratulated him after the game. I thought he was outstanding today for a large part of it. But yeah, two goals, and hopefully that now kicks him on a little bit and we start seeing the Martin that we've seen 18 months ago or so.
Yeah, I mean, of course, we brought in a few boys, and I mean, I'm assuming you're quite happy with what you've seen them produce for us so far.
Yeah. We're Sarah's staying on. We've spoke to young Bally and young Sean. Joel will go back to Ross County. His loan spell's up, so we're not going to renew that. He'll go back up, but he's been great for us. Credit to himself as a lad, and credit to his football club. He's been great around the place, great around the boys. So. It's a learning curve for him. I'm sure he's going to have a career in football, but we just feel that it's maybe we're looking for somebody else in the January window. So.
I mean, he is a young lad, let's
be honest. Yeah, he scored, and he was probably one of the catalysts when we were struggling on that bad run, and he came in, gave us a couple of goals, gave us a lift, his first goal at Peterhead, the goal down at Clyde, so he's contributed, there's no doubt about that, for them, which has been great.
Yeah, super. Just to clear up why we say that, you are convinced it was Andrew Steeves that got the first goal, because that's what I think.
Yes.
But the BBC have a different idea. Apparently they were giving it to Blair, but I thought it certainly hasn't grown a beard.
Time before Blair beard.
Exactly, that's what I thought. Great news off the pitch for us in the fact that you and Ross have agreed to extend your contracts to 2023, so I think that in itself is a massive win for us. And that's just over 3 years that you've been with us now. I mean, you consider you started and we were plumb rock bottom of League Two, and there we are, 4-0 performance against Clyde today. I mean, it must fill you with pride when you're able to watch these players.
I think it's my job's easy when you have the players that are prepared to work to do from a Tuesday, Thursday, and a Saturday, working with John and the rest of the board and everybody at the club. It makes my job easy. We've got good staff around us as well. And the fans are on board as well, so it's there'll be some harder times coming up, I've no doubt, but hopefully we'll continue. As I say, it's work in progress. There's still things that me and Ross want to achieve at the club, and we'll be striving to do that over as long as the chairman has me at the club.
I thought that was hilarious. You signed this extension, and then one sort of thing at the end, you go, well, of course, he's going to sack me one day.
It's part and parcel of the game, but hopefully that's a long way off.
Yeah. The other thing I suppose I would like to mention is that we're doing a community meal here at the club on the 23rd of December, and the idea is that we're trying to encourage people who are maybe feeling a bit lonely, and particularly this time of year, there's a lot of folk who don't have family, and apparently Tony has volunteered to help out. I mean, because you know, got a safer pair of hands for delivering the soup.
It doesn't surprise me if there's free food on the go. No, it's great. It's great. It's great what the club do and what the community do. Peter and his boys do it.
So
it's a great gesture.
Yeah. No, and I hope there's if there is anybody out there who feels they would like to come along themselves, or they know somebody else who would benefit from coming along. It's on the 23rd of December, 3 p.m. kickoff. It's being called. no more incentive required for next week's game, I suppose, than the fact that we have the opportunity to go above Falkirk and go into those playoff places.
Yeah, that's certainly, well, we certainly can go above Falkirk, and I think we'd have thought after seven games that would be halfway through the season we've got an opportunity to go above Falkirk if we beat them. So it's credit to the guys, and the run they're on just now is great, and it's a home game, so we'll be setting up to try and go and win the game. They're going to be title favourites, of course, the squad they've got, but as I say, it's a home game, we'll certainly be looking to go and win the game, and it's great for the guys to go and play against people like that they'll have in their team, and hopefully there's a decent crowd turnout as well for it.
Yeah, I think
they'll bring a few, so it'll be good, it's great, it shows where the club's coming, that we're now playing Falkirk, and maybe not just saying hoping to get a result, we're certainly going to be in the mix to try and get a result.
Yeah, there's certainly enough on that pitch to say that we'll be capable of beating anybody in this.
If we're at it, and they're maybe a wee bit off it, then we've got a real chance. Yeah. No doubt about that.
Okay, well look, all the very best for next week, looking forward to it. Don't forget Christmas jumpers. Next week, have you got a Christmas jumper?
I've got a couple of Christmas jumpers, yes.
Oh well, so I've only got 17 or 18 to pick if you're looking for one, I've got plenty. Right, anyway, take care of yourself, Stuart. Thanks very much, and a great result for the boys today. Thank you guys. Enjoy the rest of your night. Have a good one.